Hello everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting. This is part four, our next example where we have a beginning inventory but no ending inventory. So let's get right to it. Okay, so right over here, I had sales of 60,000 units during 2025. During 2025, I only produced 50,000 units, but I had 10,000 units in my beginning inventory. I sold each unit for $339. Beginning inventory consisted of 10,000 units with the following costs. Over here, I have the following costs during the current production year, and then want to go ahead and determine the cost per unit under variable and absorption costing. So I already know what my cost per unit was under for my beginning inventory. So when you look at this here, what is my cost per unit under variable and absorption costing? This is really going to be for the current year. So let's go ahead and take a look. So under variable costing, okay, I've got my direct materials, my direct labor, my variable overhead. And for the fixed factory overhead, this is a big not applicable, right? And why is that? We're going to be going ahead and expensing that immediately. So my direct materials, $40 per unit, direct labor, 50 per unit, my variable overhead. I had 1.5 million in variable overhead. I produced 50,000 units. My current year production was only 50,000 units. Even though I sold 60, the part of that's coming from my beginning inventory. So my current year production was 50,000 units. So this is going to be 1.5 million divided by 50,000 or $30 per unit. So my total cost per unit under variable costing is going to be 120. Let's take a look at absorption. So under absorption, direct materials are the same, direct labor is the same, variable overhead is the same. However, for my fixed factory overhead, which I include in absorption costing, this is going to be 4 million fixed factory overhead divided by 50,000, which is my current year production. So this is going to be 4 million. Divided by 50,000 or $80 per unit. So when I add up these four values, this is going to give me $200 per unit, which is my cost per unit under absorption costing. So let's go ahead and get to work. Okay, so we'll go ahead and do our absorption costing first. Okay, we're going to start with sales. How many units did we sell? Well, right over here, we know that we went through and we sold 60,000 units. So we've got 60,000 units. My per unit is 339. So my total sales is going to be 60,000 times 339 or 20,340,000. Okay. Now, my cost of goods sold, I'm going to do this a little bit differently. So for my current year cost of goods sold, right, I basically, where is the 60,000 coming from? Well, my current year production was 50,000 units. My per unit for my current year production under absorption is going to be $200 per unit. So I'm going to take this over here. I'm going to get $200 per unit. Okay, right over here, I've got a total of 50,000 times 200, or this is going to be $10 million. However, I'm not done. I sold 60,000. I need to have cost of goods sold for 60,000 units. When I look over here, my prior year, my beginning inventory, I had 10,000 units in my beginning inventory, and those costs consisted of two components, variable cost plus fixed factory overhead. I include the fixed factory overhead because that was in my ending inventory last year. Remember, my ending inventory becomes my beginning inventory for the following period, and the fixed factory overhead is included under absorption costing. So this is going to be 255 per unit, or a total of 2,550. So my total cost of goods sold under absorption costing is going to be $12,550,000 for a gross profit of $7,790,000. Let's go ahead and go less my selling, general, and administrative. I have my sales commissions. I sold 60,000 units. My sales commission rate is $30 per unit. My total sales commissions are $1.8 million. My fixed SG&A is going to be at $800,000. Okay, so my total SG&A under absorption costing is going to be $2.6 million. So my net income under absorption costing is going to be $7,790,000 minus $2.6 million. Gotta be careful about this. Hold on. Okay, there we go. All right. So that's going to be my net income under absorption costing. Now, when it comes to net income under variable costing, right, this is what's kind of a trip, is that when I look at this over here, this is being expensed in the current year. However, there's no ending inventory, right? And if I'm doing variable costing, what about this fixed factory overhead for these 10,000 units? If I'm doing variable costing, this was already expensed last year. So when I go through and do the cost of goods sold, I'm just going to focus over here on my variable costs. So let's go ahead and do it. For my variable costing, okay, my sales are going to be exactly the same. So over here, I've got sales, units, per unit. Sales always going to be the same. This is going to be $20,340,000 less my variable costs and my variable cost of goods sold. So my current year production, this is going to be 50,000 units. And this per unit is going to be for the current year production is going to be at 120. And we'll give this a nice little color in the Bob Ross world of painting. Okay. So my current year production for my variable cost of goods sold is going to be at $6 million. But I also have my beginning inventory. Remember, I sold 60,000 units. So I have to take 60,000 units to my cost of goods sold. So over here, my variable cost of goods sold is going to be at $130 per unit. And hopefully I didn't use the same. Well, let's go ahead and make this. We'll go ahead and make purple this up. There we go. Okay. So my variable cost of goods sold is going to be for the beginning inventory is going to be $1.3 million. Also have over here, sales commissions, right? This is going to be 60,000 units sold at $30 per unit for a total of $1.8 million. So my total variable costs are going to be 6 million plus 1.3 plus 1.8 or 9.1 million. So my contribution margin is going to be 20 million minus 9.1 less my fixed costs. So over here, my fixed costs are going to be made up of two things. My fixed factory overhead, okay, which is going to be 4 million. Now, the beginning factory, fixed factory overhead is not applicable because I fully expense that last year because I always expense factory overhead in the year that I incur it. This is in the beginning. It's irrelevant to variable costing. So over here, I'm at my fixed SG&A. My fixed SG&A is 800,000. So my total fixed costs are going to be 4.8 million. So my net income under variable costing is going to be $11,240,000 minus $4.8 million, or $6,440,000. Now, as we look at this difference here, my net income under variable costing is higher than that of the absorption costing. And what's creating that difference? Why is it higher under variable versus absorption? Well, what did we say the difference is always going to be? The difference is going to be in my fixed factory overhead. If I look at the units that were expensed to cost of goods sold and beginning inventory, I had 10,000 units in my beginning inventory. Okay, my fixed factory overhead rate per unit is going to be $125 per unit. So over here, when I take my beginning inventory units and I multiply it by the fixed factory overhead rate per unit, this is going to be my difference quantified. So what I like to usually do in my exams is I like my students to kind of go through and to identify what this difference is. The difference is always going to be in the fixed factory overhead. So here, if you have no ending inventory, but if you have a beginning inventory, in this case here, if there's no ending inventory, the net income under variable costing will be higher because this fixed factory overhead was expensed in the previous year, but it's being expensed in the current year under absorption costing. So I want to thank you for being with me here today. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them below. Appreciate you liking and subscribing to the videos. And I'm looking forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day.